my channel. It starts Deja back on it, and today we're going to be talking about Nclex strategies I use to pass my Nclex in less than 80 questions. Okay, so first thing first is, what is your institution, school, college already doing for you? Okay, because one thing is that my school provided us with ATI the entire semester, right? And I really didn't like ATI from the start. They ended up giving us a coach that would work with us at the end after we graduated, and that we would complete these modules, and by the time we complete these modules that we would be deemed ready to take the Nclex, right? Well, I wasn't feeling it. And if you're not feeling your school, you drop them. Well, not don't drop them, actually. You keep your school, because sometimes what my school did was, in order for me to get that like the permission to pass, which is what you have to get from your dean to even take the Nclex, they made us do that. And if they make y'all do that, then you do it, right? But don't let that, like, don't be like, oh my god, they're making me do this, now I have to do this and I can't do anything else. Not true at all. You can do whatever you want to do. What I did, I was in the same predicament. I didn't like ATI. It didn't provide me with rationales. It didn't provide me for the rationales for why I thought I was still right after the answer was given to me, right? So what I did was, I would end up buying Uworld. I bought Uworld for a 30-day trial, okay? Well, not a 30-day subscription. After I bought the 30-day subscription, it came with like over 1,000 questions. And I took those questions. I did about 100 questions a day from starting from June 1st to July 1st, which is when I took my exam. I had heard many, many good things about Uworld. Many people had told me that this is what they use. So I was like, I'm going to use it too, right? And it really was helpful. You were able to customize what test you wanted to take. So let's say I wanted to focus on maternity this day, heart this day, though this day, lab electrolytes this day. You could, that's what I did, and then you can break it up and take it by test. It gave you specific categories for it, and then you can choose the number of questions you want to have on that test, your fake test that you're about to take. So let's say I want to do 20 questions of fluid and electrolytes. It would come up with 20 questions just like that. So that was really helpful, and not only was Uworld really helpful, was because they provided rationales for each answer. So not only just giving me the rationale for why that answer is right, but I wanted to know the rationale for why my answer that I chose wasn't right. You know, that was confusing. Still thinking in my head, like, tell me why my answer isn't right and why this answer is. And it gives you the rationale literally for A, B, C, and D. That was very helpful. And one thing I would do is, whatever question that I got wrong, either if I got it wrong or I got it right by guessing, I would write down the rationale on a notebook, and then I would study that notebook later on. The next thing I use for my Nclex is this Nclex Saunders book. Now y'all see this book is heavy as miss, right? It's pretty heavy, and it has plenty of topics in it, right? And what I did was, I obviously did not complete the whole book, because who has time for that? And I only had 30 days to study for this exam. What I would do is, I was still currently working, so I worked 3 days a week. And when I was at work, I took my book, so I would read it. Like, I would read basic things, y'all. Like, I'm reading about fluid electrolytes, getting those numbers back in my head, studying heart rhythms. And this book also has test questions, and they also provide the rationale, but it's not the rationale for each answer like Uworld. But that's okay, because I'm only using this book for while I'm at work, or while I'm in the car, or something like that, right? I graduated Bay 9th. From May 9th to June, I worked on ATI because that was mandatory. And then after I finished that, which was around June 1st, from June 1st to June 30th, I simply studied Uworld. I did 100 questions a day, okay? And then the review paper, I would go over at night, and then I would even put it under my pillow, y'all. I wanted the information to soak into my brain. That was like an old thing my mom used to tell me about. And so I don't know if it was very superstitious, but you know what, it worked. I passed, so I guess it worked, right? And so I did the 100 questions a day. And one thing I'm gonna tell y'all I messed up is, on the day before my exam, everybody told me, stop studying. But you know, in my head, I'm like, y'all don't understand. Like, I need to pass this test. Like, my job was depending on it. I was starting in August, and then my job was like, if you fail, like, you know, you might not have a position available ready for you. And I'm like, oh my gosh. So now, you know, it's all counting on this one moment. And I'm like, you know, everybody's telling me like, you got this, you've been studying for this. I'm like, you don't understand, okay? My mind is crazy. Like, when I'm taking tests, I have terrible test anxiety, especially when it came to nursing. So back to the mistake I made, I decided to take a CC question Uworld test on all subjects. And I said if I pass, right, that would mean that, you know, I was ready to take the test and I would pass. Well, guess what, y'all? I failed. I got a 40-something on it. And that, how do you think that made my confidence right before the test? Terrible. So do not do what I did. Don't say, oh, well, any little question, no. Just stop, okay? The day before the test, you know it's really hard. Go to the pool. Go work out. Go eat at your favorite restaurant. Do anything but study or take test questions, okay? I understand if you want to, like, focus on your review papers. That's definitely understandable. I definitely did that. But as far as taking questions, I would just hold off. Because if you feel like you did, feel like I did, you're really gonna like feel terrible about yourself. And I don't want y'all to do that, because y'all can do it. The problem with taking the NCLEX is that you know you have been studying, but your fear is in the unknown. You know, you don't know what they're going to ask you. You don't know anything, right? But that's where your fear is. Leave that fear in the unknown. Trust in yourself. Trust in God. Trust in you that you have been, you know, working and preparing for this time, this entire time, and that you have it, and that you have to trust your gut. And I know it's like, I can't trust my gut. I be failing, but you got it this time. I swear, you got it this time, okay? So what you can do is when you're feeling doubtful, you know, I had post-it notes of like everything everywhere, just a super positive environment, super supportive environment. If anybody's draining you, cut them out, okay? Because you need, this is like a very hard time in your life. It's probably gonna be one of your most stressful times. Definitely was mine. I was crying all the time, y'all. So I had to take a little break during my exam because I started getting stressed out because I was comparing myself to others and like how other people had finished SCC questions. And I'm like, bro, you know, it's not working out for me. I'm about to take this daggone test again. I went to the bathroom, prayed, got myself together. I kept saying, what if your next question is your last question? You know, you got up to 100 and something questions to go. Just stay positive. So even if, you know, you keep hitting question after question, y'all, stay positive, because you don't know what question is going to end. That is the worst thing about taking the NCLEX is the unknown, that you don't know if you're doing good or if you're doing bad, and that you don't know when is your last question. But take each question as your last question, and I promise you will be good, okay? You have been preparing for this. You got this. You own this. You walked in there confident. Just know you can do it. And then after 3 hours later, do the trick. Try to pay with your credit card. If it don't let you pay, you know you probably did pass. Didn't pay for the expedited results because I just couldn't wait. And then you get your results and then you'll see that you pass. And then you'll be just like being stressing about everything else about nursing and trying to educate others and just trying to get people to, you know, be aware of today's times and, you know, what it's like to be a nurse right now and everything else that's going on, right? So that's all I have for you guys. Please comment below, let me know which one is your favorite topic. Tell me what you guys would like me to talk about next. Always follow me at Native Love. Always follow me at Nurse Deja, and I promise I'll be giving you guys content as much as I can every Thursday. Y'all stay tuned for my next video, and thank you so much for tuning in.